Hello student, good morning. Today we are going to see another article under unit number 1. The name of the article is Network Topology. Previously we have seen the physical organization of parallel platform. In that article, we learned how the physical computers are communicated with other computers and memory in a network architecture. So that architecture is called as PRAM machine, parallel random access machine. Now there are different network topologies available to organize the processor and memory in parallel platforms. So a variety of network topology have been proposed and implemented. This topology trade off performance for cost. Commercial machine often implement hybrid of multiple topology for reasons of packaging, cost and available components. Some of the simplest and earliest parallel machines use the bus topology. All processor access a common bus for exchanging data. The distance between any two nodes is big O of 1 in a bus. The bus also provides a convenient broadcast media. However, the bandwidth of the shared bus is the major bottleneck. Typical bus-based machines are limited to dozens of nodes. Sun Enterprise Server and Intel-based shared multiprocessor are example of such architectures. Here you can see the bus topology, where the address bus and data bus are communicated to the processor 0 and 1, and they are accessing a global memory. Now the figure A is without local cache and figure B with local cache. So what is the use of cache? Cache can improve the performance of bus-based machines. Now here, another topology, that is a crossbar network. Crossbar network uses the P by M grid of switches to connect P inputs to M outputs in a non-blocking manner. Here you can see in this figure, the processors are shown at the left-hand side and the memory banks are shown on the top of the architectures, where each processor is communicated with the memory with the help of switching element. As shown in this figure, it is elaborated here. If the switch is open, then there is no communication between processor and memory. If the switch is closed, then there is a communication between processor and memory. A completely non-blocking crossbar network connecting P processor to B memory bank is shown in this figure. Now, the cost of the processor of P processor grows as big O of P square. This is generally difficult to scale for large values of P. Now what is the drawback of this crossbar switch? You can see here, as the number of processors are goes on increasing and increasing, we require a number of switches, crossbar switches. So processor, no doubt about that, the processors are going to increase every day. So as the processors are increasing, number of processors are increasing, the more number of switches are required. That is a drawback of this crossbar switch. Now you can see here, the example of machine that employs the crossbar includes Sun Ultra HPC 10,000 is the example of this crossbar switches. Now this drawback of crossbar switch can also overcome by using another type of network topology, that is Omega switches multi-stage network. Crossbar have excellent performance scalability but poor cost scalability. Buses has excellent cost scalability but poor performance scalability. Now the combination of these good properties of crossbar and buses are communicated and we form a multi-stage interconnected that strike the compromise between bus and crossbar switches. Now this multi-stage network is shown here, where processors are communicated with memory banks with the help of stage 1, stage 2, stage n. A schematic of typical multi-stage interconnection network is shown in this figure. Now, the network topology, multi-stage Omega network, one of the most commonly used multi-stage interconnected is the Omega network. Now, Omega network is the similar to the crossbar, but that is a 2x2 Omega having two inputs and two outputs. As shown in this figure, you can clear this. This is a multi-stage Omega network where two inputs and two outputs are given sometimes the omega is passed through as shown in this figure A, and sometimes the omega is crossover as shown in this figure A. Sorry, figure B. The perfect shuffle patterns are connected using 2x2 switches. Now, what is this shuffling? Here, you can see in this figure, each stage of omega network implement a perfect shuffle as below. So here the input and the outputs. Input is shuffled and interconnected to the output. That is the idea behind this multi-stage omega network that can be easily done with the help of this multi-stage omega network. Now, a complete omega network with a perfect shuffle interconnects and switches can show in this figure. So here you can see omega network has p/2 into log p switching nodes, and the cost of such network grows as p log p. Now, what is the routing in multi-stage omega network? Let S be the binary representation of source and D be that of destination processor. The data traverse the link to the first switching nodes. If the most significant bits of S and D are same, then the data is routed in pass-through mode by switching element. Else, it is gone through crossover network. So this process is repeated for each of the log P switching stages. Note that this is not a non-blocking type of switch. Now here a complete figure is shown as an example of blocking in omega network. One message, that is 0102111 or 1102100, is blocked at link A and B. Now another type of network topology, like completely connected network, each processor is connected to every other processor. That is a completely connected network. The number of links in the network scale as big O P square. While the performance scales very well, the hardware complexity is not reliable for large values of P. In this sense, these networks are static counterparts of crossbar switch. Here you can see the completely connected and star connected network topology as an example of 8-node completely connected network. Figure A shows completely connected network of 8 nodes, and figure B shows star connected network for 9 nodes. Now, what is star connected network? Every node is connected only to common node at a center. So that is a bottleneck. If the center node collapses or fails or goes under troubleshooting or maintenance, then entire network topology can collapse. That is a drawback of star connected network. In this sense, the star connected network are static counterparts of bus topology. Another type of network topology is their linear array, mesh, k-dimensional mesh. So what is a linear array? Each node has 2 neighbors, one to its left and one to its right. If the nodes at either end are connected, we refer to it as one-dimensional torus or ring. A generalization of 2 dimension has nodes with 4 neighbors to the north, south, east, and west. A further generalization of d dimension has nodes with 2-dimensional neighbors. A special case of d-dimensional mesh is hypercube. Here, D is equal to log P, where P is the total number of nodes. Now, network topology linear array can be shown in this figure with no wraparound links, and figure B with wraparound links. So what do you mean by wraparound? So wraparound means the output is again given to the first node as an input. That is nothing but a wraparound link. Now, some of the linear array are wraparound and some of the linear array are without wraparound link. Now, again, there are 2- and 3-dimensional meshes. This is a very widely used network topology in parallel platforms. This figure shows 2-dimensional mesh with no wraparound. Figure B, 2-dimensional mesh with a wraparound. That is 2-dimensional torus, and figure C is 3-dimensional mesh with no wraparound. Now, another network topology is hypercube, and their construction is shown in this figure. Construction of the hypercubes from hypercubes of lower destination dimensions. Now, what are the properties of hypercubes? The distance between any 2 nodes is at most log P. Each node has log P neighbors. The distance between 2 nodes is given by number of bit position at which the two nodes differ. Now, another type of network topology widely used, that is a tree-based network shown here, where the circles are nothing but the processing element and the squares are switching elements. First figure shows the static tree network and figure B is nothing but the dynamic tree network. So what are the properties of this tree-based network? The distance between any two nodes is not more than 2 log T. Link higher up the tree potentially carry more traffic than those at lower level. For this reason, a variant called fat tree patterns the link as we go up the tree. Tree can be laid out in two dimensions with no wire crossing. This is an attractive property of the tree. So here you can see the fat tree with the 16 processing nodes. So this overcome the drawback of tree-based networks. Now, another important topic in this network topology is that how to evaluate the performance of the network. Now we have seen various topology, right from bus to fat tree, then hypercube and the star connected network and mesh and linear array. So how to evaluate the performance of this network topology? So there are three factors, three parameters like diameter, bisection width, cost. So what is the diameter? The distance between the farthest two nodes in the network. The diameter of a linear array is t minus 1 and that of mesh is 2 in root t minus 1. And that of tree and hypercube is log t and that of completely connected network is big O of 1. And that is the diameter. This is one parameter of evaluating the static network connection. Now, second parameter is bisection width. What is bisection width? The minimum number of wires you must cut to divide the network into two equal parts, that is a bisection width. Bisection width of linear array and tree is 1 and that of mesh is root p and that of hypercube is p by 2 and that of completely connected network is p square by 4. Now third parameter is cost. The number of link or switches, whichever is asymptotically higher, is meaningful measure of cost. However, the number of other factors such as ability to lay out the network, length of wires, etc. also factor in cost of network. So these are the three factors for evaluating the static interconnection network. Now here this table shows the static interconnection network's evaluation parameters. Parameters are shown at the right left hand side, like various topology, connected network, star network, completely binary tree, linear array. And at the right hand side, you can see the factors which affect or which use for evaluating the interconnection network parameters performance. These are diameter, bisection width, arc connectivity, and cost of the network. This is about static interconnection network. Figure next figure shows you the evaluating dynamic interconnection network. So here dynamic interconnection networks are only three types of network topology: crossover, omega network, and dynamic tree. So this is all about the network topology of the parallel platforms, where you can use the network topology right from the bus up to your hypercube, mesh, star connected, fat tree, tree-based network, and all other things. So this is the end of this article. In the next, we will see the another important article, that is communication cost of parallel machines. Thank you very much.